In today's video, I'm going to show you two quick but very important tips to help speed up your PC flipping process. That way you can make some more money. Let's get into it. Hey, welcome to Zach's Tech Turf. So I know a lot of you are out there trying to make some money on flipping PCs. It's kind of hard to do right now with the world events going on, but either way, I'm gonna share with you two quick tips that help me sell my PC builds faster. And if you're new here and you wanna see other PC related content videos just like this one, then hit that subscribe button down below and also that notification bell. That way you never miss an episode. But yeah, let's make some more money. Big thanks to ASRock and their new Z490 motherboards for sponsoring today's video. All right, so I don't wanna waste a ton of time in this video. Y'all gotta get out there and slay those PC flips. So the very first tip that I have is that you not only should, but need to post both the full specs and benchmarking results for all of your PC builds. The second tip will go hand in hand with this one. It'll actually help you set up the benchmarks faster, but let's stick with this one first. As you can see here at some of these examples, these are exactly what you do not wanna do when selling your PC builds. Posting a multi-$100 product in the attempt to get someone to buy it without the proper amount of information is possibly what's setting you back right now. I mean, think about it. Imagine that you go to the car dealership and you go up to a car and you can only see the price tag. Sure, you can look inside the window or you can pop the hood, but without getting the full spec sheet, you won't know what that car is capable of. Would you buy it? That's essentially the same concept that I see a ton of these PC flippers doing, and it's probably a huge reason why they aren't selling fast. What I recommend doing and what I do with all of my PC flips, take a look at some of the examples going on the screen right now, is to always include not only the full spec sheet, like literally every part, not just the CPU and GPU, but to also have the benchmarking results for the popular games. Here you can see on these ads that I typically benchmark Fortnite, CSGO, PUBG, and I really should be including Grand Theft Auto 5. What I would recommend doing is taking a peek at the most popular Twitch livestream games and benchmarking about 5 of the most popular games outside of the super easy to run ones like Hearthstone. This helps out so much when people are willing to spend multi-hundreds of dollars on a gaming PC because they're gonna wanna know how much FPS it gets in these popular games. I wouldn't know this from experience because I've been doing this with all my PC build flips for like the last 5 years or so, but I guarantee those of you that aren't following this rule, you get a ton of DMs and messages asking how much FPS it's gonna get in Fortnite. Now don't get me wrong, even if you post exactly how many FPS it gets in Fortnite, you're still gonna get some of those 12-year-old kids that only read the title and ask you that exact question. Kindly point them to the posting again. They'll look at how you have multiple games benchmarked and you're that much closer to making the sale. So now you may be wondering if it's worth spending all that extra time loading Windows, downloading all those stupid game launchers and actually benchmarking those games. And that's where the second tip comes in. And this one is even gonna apply to you non-PC flippers, and that's to use Chocolaty. I'm guessing that a lot of you don't know what this is. I'm actually super excited to explain it to you. Chocolaty is essentially like a Linux package manager that allows you to quickly install software packages from the command line, and boy does it save a ton of time. The Chocolaty repo or repository is jam-packed with a bunch of useful software that we all use every day, and this repo is even security checked by the community so you have some good confirmation that these are safe to use. Here you can see me setting up a brand new freshly installed Windows machine. This is a virtual machine by the way, but that doesn't change anything. Let me know down in the comment section if you want me to do a video on virtualization, but here I'm going to walk you through the steps real quickly. First, you open up the command prompt as an administrator and paste in the Chocolaty install command. I'll have it linked down in the description. This installs Chocolaty, but before you actually use it, you'll want to close and reopen the command prompt. Do that, and then it takes a single command line to not only download, but silently install a huge list of programs that you need to start benchmarking your computer. Here you can see that I typed in MSI Afterburner, Steam, Epic Game Launcher, CPU-Z, Google Chrome, Discord, Battle.net, Uplay, and Origin. For some reason, Battle.net won't silently install. You'll have to click the next button for this one, but other than that, after the command runs for a bit, you'll see that we now have all of these programs installed with shortcuts on the desktop, and just like that, you're ready to start benchmarking your PC. Chocolaty saves an insane amount of time. Think about how much time you would spend going to all of those game launcher websites, choosing what operating system you want to download, clicking through all those installation menus. Chocolaty just does it all for you. It's awesome. Outside of the packages that we just installed, some of the other useful ones that you may be interested in are Firefox, Adobe Reader, 7-Zip, VLC, Notepad++, and there's a ton of code coding and programming software on there, such as Python and Visual Studio Code. Now, like I said, Chocolaty is awesome even if you aren't a PC flipper because you can install software so quickly, but where things get really fun is that if you want to update your software later on down the line, you can type in this single command and that'll update all of the software that you install with Chocolaty. So hopefully those tips will serve you all well. I personally think that posting all of the specs and benchmarking results of your builds will help eliminate time-wasting conversations with potential buyers. It'll also put on a professional front that you know what you're doing, and using the Chocolaty package manager will save a significant amount of time getting those benchmarking runs set up for you. Well, that wraps up my two tips for making you money faster with PC flipping. As always, drop a comment down below about what you thought of these tips or what other tips you want to see me make a video on. After that, feel free to head on over to one of these two videos if you haven't seen them yet. Definitely hit that subscribe button and make sure you're following me over on Twitch, because that's where the real fun has been happening.